So our sermon series throughout Lent will be Journey to the Cross. And I love this image, Journey to the Cross, because the pathway looks like a cross. It is a crossroads. We have a choice whether we will take that path that leads to the cross. And today we choose that path with confidence, with knowing who we are, and Jesus knowing who he is. To know who you are is the title of our sermon. We all go through times of discovery, discovering who we are. And you know, when I thought of Jesus' life, I thought, you know, he always knew who he was. You know, when he was, you know, maybe 12 years old and in the temple and sitting in Jerusalem, and his parents had left, and he was still left in the temple and asking questions of the leaders, the rabbis. And it's like there was always this sense he knew who he was. But you know, I think this temptation passage was one of those that he had to decide, was he really going to be who he was called to be? Was he going to follow this hard path, this that he was called to do? And Jesus said yes. Jesus said, yes, I am going to continue. He had come to those crossroads, and I am going to take that path to the cross. I am not going to take any shortcuts. And that's exactly what Satan was offering him. And he was offering him to be less than what he was called to be less than the Messiah, to be less than what he was called to be. You know, Satan always wanted to be more than he was. He always wanted more power, more control. That's why he was thrown out of heaven. And he tempted Adam and Eve to be more than what they could be, made it look like it was more, but to actually be less. It turned out to be less. And Satan comes with these same temptations to Jesus and also sometimes in our own lives. You know, there are two times in Scripture that God speaks. God the Father speaks out of heaven and declares that Jesus is the Son of God. It's at his Jesus baptism. And last week we looked at the Transfiguration, where this voice declares, "This is my Son, my beloved Son, the one in whom I am well pleased." Jesus did know who he is. But yet he didn't have to go around declaring who he was. When he lived here in human flesh, when he was walking around, you know, he wasn't standing on the mountaintops saying, "Look at me, I'm the Messiah. I'm the one that you've been waiting for." He didn't go around declaring, "I'm Jesus." He left people discover that on their own and pointed everyone to his Father, to God. It's interesting, even when he is arrested, kind of jumping forward in the story, when he's arrested and he's on trial, when he's before Caiaphas, the high priest, you know, he doesn't go in there bursting forth saying, "Yep, I'm the Messiah," but he's silent. And with Pilate, he's silent. When he's even asked, "Who are you? Are you?" He's silent until both of them, Caiaphas and Pilate both, they say, "Are you the Messiah?" And he responds, "It is as you say. You have said it." Jesus didn't have to say it. "You have said it," he replies to Caiaphas and to Pilate. We are looking at this passage of Scripture today where Peter is asked, "Who do people say I am?" That's the first thing he asks to the disciples, to Jesus asks. "Who do people say I am?" Well, some say you're Elijah, some say you're Moses, some say you're other prophet. And Jesus looks at the disciples and said, "Who do you say I am?" And Peter answers, "You are the Messiah. You are the Son of the living God." To which Jesus replies, "You know this because it's been revealed to you by God. It's like your heart has seen this." Our first point this morning is Jesus could only do what he did because he knew who he was. Jesus could only do, next slide please, Joe. Jesus could only do what he did because he knew who he was. He knew he was the Son of God. He didn't have to go around and tell other people. And when that voice spoke out of the clouds at his baptism, it wasn't because Jesus needed to hear that. It was because the people, the crowd needed to hear it. The disciples needed to hear it. The transfiguration, Peter, James, and John needed to hear it. We needed to read it in scripture and hear it. Jesus, it wasn't for his benefit. He knew who he was, and he had his sight set on the cross because he knew who he was. He knew what he was called to do. He didn't need to defend himself when he was before Pilate and Caiaphas. He knew who he was. You know, sometimes in life, we kind of repeat things because we want to remember them. Sometimes we do that in church. You know, I say, you are a child of God, and you repeat, I am a child of God, because we need to grasp that truth. We need to live into that. Jesus knew who he was. And he confidently faced the cross because he knew what he had come to do. He knew what he was born to come to do. He was born from cradle to cross, sometimes we say. He went from the cradle and his sights were on the cross. He knew that this was his destiny. So when Jesus asked the disciples who people were saying he was, and when Jesus asked who they thought he was, he wasn't doing so because he didn't know, or because he needed to hear it, but he said it because he needed them to voice it. He needed the disciples to voice it. He didn't need an affirmation. Oh, yeah, you go. You keep going and doing what you're doing, Jesus. No, the disciples needed to hear it. They needed to say it. When Peter said it, it became real to Peter. To say something out loud makes it real, and Peter was able to say it. You are the Son of God. You are the Son of the living God. You are the Messiah. It was a declaration. It was a statement of truth. It was Peter putting himself out there. And Jesus says, yes, it has been revealed to you. But you know what? In that very moment that Peter declares who Jesus is and knows and states exactly who Jesus is, Peter discovers who he is. Because Jesus right away turns around and says, Peter, you are the rock. Your name is Peter. Our second point today, knowing who Jesus is, we know who we are. Knowing who Jesus is, we know who we are. Knowing who Jesus is defines who we are. You know, that statement to Peter, that you are the rock, and on you I will build my church. Some look at that as a special call for Peter, and it was a special call. Peter is very much instrumental in the early life of the early church. But I stand with one commentator. I thought this, and I'm glad this commentator thought so too. It kind of verifies it. But it says, others who share this proclamation that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God share Peter's authority to build the church. Just the same as we declare, Jesus, you are the Son of God, that gives us a responsibility to keep declaring that Jesus is the Son of God. We find our own identity and our own meaning in life to live and to declare and to share who Jesus Christ is. That name, Peter, it means rock. We think of a rock, we think of something rock solid, a solid foundation, something unbreakable, that's firm. Jesus was confident. He was firm in who he was. And now he turns to Peter, and Peter has that same confidence now, or Jesus has that confidence in Peter, that he will be the rock. He will be a part of the establishment of the church. And so Jesus says in this passage, as we declare that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of the living God, he turns to us and he tells us, be a rock. Be rock solid, be confident, be who I have called you to be. Sometimes we too, as I talked about Jesus being tempted by Satan, and that would have, giving in to that temptation made him less than what he was called to be. Sometimes we too are tempted to be less than what we are called to be. we have a great destiny before us as well. When we find and we declare who Christ is, we find who we are. I want to share a modern story that kind of tells that. There's a movie that was released by the title of Moana, and it has become a real hit in our family. Moana is about a 16-year-old girl who's trying to kind of find her way in life. She is actually born in her, her father is the chief of a tribe, and she is going to become chief of the tribe. And so it's about her kind of learning how to be chief. But it's about a people who are finding out who they are as well, finding their identity. They've stayed on this island for a couple of generations now, and that island cannot sustain them anymore. Where are they going to do? What are they going to do? Well, Moana discovers there are boats on that island that have been hidden away. They were once voyagers. They once went out and set sail and found new lands. When an island couldn't sustain them, they would move on to another island and they would stay at that island. And so it's, again, a discovery of Moana, who she is, and this people, who they are as voyagers, discovering her identity. We're going to watch a clip of this, and it's two songs that are put together from the movie, Know Who You Are, and then a song called I Am Moana, her discovering who she is. And there are different scenes. It's not just one scene from the movie, but from these two songs, you see a whole bunch of scenes from this movie. Let's watch it.
To find you,
on the top of my mind,
I know your name. They have stolen the heart from inside you. But this does not define you. This is not who you are. You know who you are. I am a girl who loves my island and the girl who loves the sea. It calls me. I am the daughter of the village chief. We are descended from voyagers who found their way across the world. And they call me. I've delivered us to where we are. I have journeyed farther. I am everything I've learned and more.
As Moana finds who she is, and by the way, that DVD comes out Tuesday. If you want to watch it, you can rent it. As Moana finds out who she is, she helps her people rediscover who they are. We too, as the people of God, must discover our identity. As we know the name of God, as we know and declare who Jesus is, we know our name. We know who we are. like Peter, sometimes we can be fearful of our call and who we are. Peter, he discreetly viewed from a distance when Jesus was arrested, watching to see what would happen. The women at the tomb the first morning of the resurrection, they peered in because that tomb wasn't supposed to be empty. They came expecting it to be closed, sealed, and it was not. Fearful disciples between the resurrection and Pentecost hid away in an upper room because they didn't understand and they were afraid of what was going to happen and what was happening before them. We know the whole story. We can journey toward the cross with confidence because we know the end of the story. We know Jesus is the Son of the living God. And we know Jesus suffered death on a cross and rose again to bring us life. We are an Easter people. Even in the midst of Lent, we are an Easter people. Remember, Sundays are like little Easters. Every week, working up to that resurrection day, we travel toward the cross. We do so with confidence because in death we find life. We are a Pentecostal people because we know that Jesus, as he ascended into the heavens, he sent the Holy Spirit so that we could be empowered and have his presence living in us. To empower us for the ministry he gives us on earth. You are called, we are called to be the people of God. Serve the Lord your God. You are given authority to build the church. You are all Peters, you are all rocks. We are the people of God, and to know Christ, we know who we are. That song, Who Am I, that Moana sings, I kind of took it and I rewrote it. I'm going to read words to you. They might not be like, probably couldn't sing it along with the melody because it wouldn't match up perfectly, but just very quickly in minutes, these words come to me. This is what I hear when she sings. I hear, who am I? I am the one who loves God. I'm the one who loves God's world. God calls me. I am that daughter, that son of the God who reigns over the world. We are disciples. The saints who have gone before, they cheer us on. God has placed us where we are. We journey together. We learn and grow. Still, God calls. The call is inside our hearts. We hear the voice of God. Continue to hear the voice in your heart to remind you that come what may, you know the way. I am, you are, we are called of God. We are called of God. Know who Jesus is. Jesus knew who he was. Know who Jesus is. And therefore know who you are. Moana had this mantra through the movie. Every time she needed, remember, said repetition and saying things out loud kind of helps us know who we are or know what we're doing. She had this mantra. I am Moana from Motunui. You will board my boat, you sail across the sea and restore the heart of Te Fiti. She says that numerous times through the movie, reminding herself, kind of gathering up courage. You know what our mantra is? Do you know what the Christian mantra is? If I were to choose a mantra, if you were to choose a mantra, what would it be? John 3:16. You know, we post John 3:16 thinking everybody knows John 3:16. Not everybody does, but we do, don't we? Because that's our mantra. God so loved the world. God so loved you and me that he sent his only begotten son to die, and this is a little paraphrase, but to die on a cross. To take our sins to a cross so that we might have life, so that we will not perish. Embrace that life today. Embrace that life. In a moment, we are going to have communion together, and that reminds us of that life. Stand with me. Will you please? Repeat after me. Jesus asks, "Who do you say I am?" And you respond, "Jesus, you are the Messiah. Jesus, you are the Messiah, the Son of the living God."
The Son of the living God.
Amen. Let us sing.